Yes, you are welcome once again, my people. Yahoo Yahoo, I know according to my other video, Yahoo Yahoo means the name, the slang, you know, the language they use when they are talking about fraud, internet fraud, you know, that so many people are into now. So it's the language that they use. They call it Yahoo Yahoo, you know, fraud through internet. So this is it. And I said something to you also. I said about getting rich through lying means what the Bible said. So the scripture, as I was doing the video, so I can really take time to get it. But now I found it. So we can, you know, just listen and hear. Proverbs chapter 21 verse 6. Proverbs chapter 21 verse 6. So just listen so that you understand very clearly, you know, everything is in the word of God. So getting treasures by a lying tongue is the fleeting fantasy of those who seek death. Again, I read you, you know, Proverbs 21, the book of Proverbs 21, verse 6. Getting treasures by a lying tongue is the fleeting fantasy of those who seek death. So I thank you. You are very okay, so we move on. I move on. Today I will be talking about something about what God gave to me, what God said about Nigerian pastors. I'll be calling them one by one, and because it's a pain in the heart of God. God said to me, expose everything that I give to, because it is only light that makes manifest, that exposes. The Bible says the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness can never comprehend it, you know, can never stop it, cannot quench it. So there is a lot of power in the light to expose every darkness. Darkness is very weak. Darkness is as weak as anything you can think about. There's no power in darkness. There's no power in evil. You know, they are fearful, but there is boldness, you know, in truth, in righteousness. So understand that devil is weak and fearful. Anytime, I don't care if I'm lying down or I'm okay, anytime that animal show, I destroy him. No, he's not really after man like that. No, you know, he is just after those that he will rear through his cunning, through his lying, through his, you know, through his, he's a very cunning animal. But God, Allah, he's a servant of God. The devil is a servant of God. All are his servants. The devil is supposed to be serving man. God first. When God is in front of you, when you put God number one, when God is number one in your life, Bible said that in the beginning, God, in the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, said, in the beginning, God. So when you put God first in your life and be at his back, understand at the back of God, so you are the second person, God first, you second. The next thing, the devil will be at your back serving you. You'll be controlling the devil. You'll be controlling him. You know, he become your boy, your servant. You know, he become your servant. Become a boy, you know. So the devil is a servant. He's there to serve man. Bible said, you know, that when he, Christ, ascended on high, he led captivity captive. He led captivity. Who is he talking to? The devil that is holding men and the women in captivity. The hold men in captive. He sees the devil. He holds him captive. He puts a rope or a chain on his neck. And as Jesus, you know, is busy driving his car, he tied the devil at, you know, at the boot, you know, the back of his car. As he's driving his car, anywhere he go, anywhere he drive his car, the devil is following him. And anyhow, he want to control him, you know, the devil is in captivity in the hand of Jesus. Nigeria would have been heaven on earth if all these people that call themselves men of God, pastors, prophets, teachers, prophetesses, or not, whatever. If those men that call themselves bishops, if they are operating with the Spirit of Jesus, Nigeria would have been heaven on earth. There is no way evil would have stand. But because they go to the devil, they go and get power from the devil. That's why that country is filled with darkness. I don't want to go more than this for now. Let's hear something. I want to talk to you now about Adeboye. Adeboye, as I said to you before, is a white garment church man. The man that started that Redeemed Christian Church of God was a Yoruba man. I don't know his name. He's a Yoruba man. But he is the one that started that church or that ministry, or no, I don't know. He is a, the man is a white garment churchman. He acquired enough power. You know, in Yoruba, they have so many powers. They have God called Ogu, God of Iron, Thunder of Thunder, the God of this. They have the one in the forest, Ifa. The one in the forest, they call it Ifa. In fact, if not that God is God, Yoruba people or Yoruba men would have used juju and get moon and get sun, get heaven down. They would have used their evil power and get moon down. If not that God is God, these people have what is called dangerous evil powers in their land, and they are worshipping strong idols. They don't believe in God. But the funny thing is that they believe that church belongs to them. That they so much believe one thing, that church belongs to them. Are they the only one that knows God? Ask yourself this. I'm not against that. If they are doing the will of God, if they are operating in God's Spirit, I would have loved them more than anybody, any person or any tribe. But the problem is, if you look into what I'm about to say now, Adeboye came from Yoruba land. Oyedepo from Yoruba land. Tibi Joshua from Yoruba land. Tunde Bakari, Yoruba land. Matthew Shimalobe from Yoruba land. And so many of them. So many of them. I just don't know. But assuming they are doing the will of God, all these things wouldn't have been. I wouldn't have been talking about this. But the reason why I'm talking about it is because of what I saw happen. So, they are busy exalting the powers in their land, the evil powers in their land. That's why if you go into the villages of Yoruba land, you will be surprised, you will marvel for what you see. The highest atrocity is happening in their land, happening in even Lagos State, where they put they say the highest church in the whole world, the highest church is this, all is Yoruba. If you go inside, I do go inside the internet, I see a lot. Building house, God is not interested in what you are building. He is not interested in what you are doing. If God's Spirit is not found in you, you are none of His. You don't belong to Him. If God's Spirit is not found in you, you did not belong to Him. The Spirit of righteousness, the Spirit of truth. If this Spirit is not found in you, you are a man of devil. So I saw the man, let me repeat this again. You know, God spoke to me, said the man acquired a lot of power, and he can't, according to how it happened, so the man want to do something that, he moved so many places and acquired power and feel the power in his body. But he can't carry it on again. He can't move it anymore. So I could have told him that he have to die. No, that he have to transfer the power to another person. He choose Adeboye. and say that this is the guy and introduce him as the guy that will move the church or the redeemed church to the next level and this and that, because the man acquired a lot of powers. So he lay hand upon Adeboye, transferred those powers. After some time, he died. He is dead, but due to the evil power he acquired, he's still living. He's one living because he transferred those powers inside of him. He lay hand upon him. So he's, you know, spiritual, he's one living. He's living inside of him. He's one moving him. That's why God said to me, it's dead spirit. Dead spirit. Dead spirit. The man is dead, but he's living because he transferred the power to him. Spiritually, he is inside of him, moving him, you know, carrying on the evil mission, evil plan. Okay, Adeboye is operating with his spirit because the man is a white garment church man. He collected power from so many places. So many places. Before he died and transferred those powers to Adeboye. That's why a lot of tragedy do happen. Maybe at times I do see maybe something will happen. So many times I see the pastors went to the place or to their camp and they were coming back, their boss, you know, was. They had many things happen, tragedy. You know, the pastor and the members of the church, they all wiped out. The other time, a container fell out, somebody, you know, tragedy was happening. So many things happening, and they will say, oh, it is the will of God. It is not the will of God. God is able to protect his children. God is able to save his children. God is able to see that no evil befall his children. Okay, let it be. If you are working for God, those things happen. Anything can happen. Then one can say it is the will of God. Nobody can question God. But you know, at the point, you know clearly. I'm talking to you. You know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. You don't have God's spirit. No God's spirit in you. You are operating with a dead spirit. Causing havoc and pains to the people. It's not that you have the highest congregation is what matters. No. What matters is how many people did you prepare for heaven? How many people that heaven can say yes to your life, they are a candidate that whenever they leave this world, they will be with the Lord. They will be in heaven, enjoying everlasting. You know what I'm talking about? You yourself, you're not saved. You don't know Jesus. You don't know Jesus. White garments church people in Nigeria, I face a lot of things in their hand. Those people is eating with devil. They eat in the same plate with devil. They don't worship God. They worship powers on the water. They worship all kinds of, they worship Satan. They eat one, they sit on the same table, eat with Satan and demons. But Nigeria could believe anyway, they see something happening, they don't want to confirm. What Bible says, test all spirit and know the one that comes from the Lord. A Buddha man will come from India and come and say, and give faith. Fake testimony, I come in contact with Jesus, and Jesus do me this, and Jesus do me that. All of them will say, oh, hallelujah, lay hand upon me. You guys have become a dumping ground where any man can come anytime and discharge and dump evil spirit and dump in your body and dump evil spirit and go. This is what you guys have done. They come and they lie to people because they know that people doesn't know what is called test all spirit and know the one that comes from God. Anywhere they come from, they come and discharge, lay hand, discharge upon all of you and take your money and go away. It's a pain in the heart of God. It's a painful thing in the heart of God. But there's something else I should read to you, Adeboye. God gave me something to read and I want to do it now. Isaiah 28, I want to read something for you to hear. book of Isaiah chapter 28. Isaiah 28 from verse 1. I want to read something for you right here. Isaiah chapter 28, this is what God said that you read for you a debut to hear. I want to read it now. Just listen. Isaiah 28 from verse 1 to 22. Woe to the crown of pride, to the drunkards of Ephraim, whose glorious beauty is a fading flower which is at the head of the verdant valley. To those who are overcome with wine, behold, the Lord has a mighty and a strong one, like a tempest of hail and a destroying storm, like a flood of mighty waters overflowing. Who will bring them down to the earth with his hand? God said that he will bring you down. Who will bring you down to the earth with his hands? With his hand. The almighty hand will bring all of you down. The crown of pride. You came to be, you know, people look at you, they say maybe you're humble, no? You know, that is fake humility, fake humility. You're not really humble, fake humility. You are very proud because the one inside of you is proud, is a proudful one, the devil. You know, you are very proud, very proudful person with you. You pretend, in the outward, you pretend to be humble. But listen, the crown of pride, the drunkard of Ephraim will be trampled underfoot, and the glorious beauty is a fading flower which is at the valley of the verdant valley. Like the first fruit before the summer, which an observer sees, he eats it up while it is still in his hand. In that day, the Lord of hosts will be for a crown of glory and a diadem of beauty to the remnant of his people, for a spirit of justice to him who sits in judgment, and for strength, to those who turn back the battle at the gate. But they also have erred through wine and through intoxicating drink out of the way. The priest and the prophet have erred through intoxicating drink. They are swallowed up by wine. They are out of the way through intoxicating drink. They err in vision. They stumble in judgment. For all tables are full of vomit and filth. No place is clean. No place is clean. I'm reading Isaiah 28 from verse 1 to 22. I'm reading verse 9 now. Whom will he teach knowledge, and whom will he make to understand the message? Those just weaned from milk, those just drawn from the breasts. For precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little, there a little. For with stammering lips and another tongue, he will speak to his people, to whom he said, this is the rest with which you may cause the weary to rest. And this is the refreshing, yet they would not hear. But the word of the Lord was to them precept upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little, there a little, that they might go and fall backward and be broken and snared and caught. Therefore, hear the word of the Lord, you scornful men. You are mocking yourself. Scornful men think you are mocking God. Therefore, hear the word of the Lord, you scornful men, who rule these people who are in Jerusalem, in Redeem, you know, in all these churches. Because you have said, look at what you said. Because you have said, we have made a covenant with death, and with swear we are in agreement. You think you are in agreement with a dead man, with death? Think you are in agreement. Just listen very careful. Listen very careful. I read again from verse 15. Because you have said, we have made a covenant with death, and with swear we are in agreement. When the overflowing scourge passes through, it will not come to us. For we have made lies. The lying tongues have made lies our refuge, and under falsehood we have hidden ourselves. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion a stone for a foundation, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. Whoever believes will not act hastily. Also, I will make justice the measuring line and the righteousness the promise. The hail, Bible says, the hail will sweep away the refuge of lies, and the waters will overflow the hidden places. Your covenant with death will be annulled, and your agreement with swear will not stand. When the overflowing scourge passes through, then you will be trampled down by it. As often as it goes out, it will take you. For morning by morning, it will pass over, and by day and by night, it will be a terror just to understand the report. For the bed is too short to stretch out on, and the covering so narrow that one cannot wrap himself in it. For the Lord will rise up as at Mount Perazim. He will be angry as in the valley of Gibeon, that he may do his work, that the Almighty may do his work, his awesome work, and bring to pass his act, his unusual act. Now, therefore, do not be mockers, lest your bone be made strong, for I have heard from the Lord, God of hosts, a destruction determined even upon the whole earth, upon all the whole earth. You that think you are in agreement with death, death spirit, death will take you. Death, that covenant is broken now, and the hell will sweep the refuge of lies. This is what the Almighty gave me to give to you, Adeboye. Your covenant with death is broken. Enough. Your covenant with death is broken. You know correctly what I'm saying. You know what I'm talking about. Your covenant, that's why where you are doing your so-called monetary something is graveyard. I do see you in the graveyard. Every time I see you in a graveyard, what are you doing in the graveyard? Anytime you are, before you do your monetary something, you go round with a dog. You put on your the white cross tied, you know, cross it like this. You go round with a dog. What are you doing with the dog and the tie? Because that's a sign of Ifa. Ifa, you know what I'm talking about. The occult in Yoruba land called Ifa. You tie your rope, go around the place, and you stand, you are calling Jesus. That Jesus you are calling is after you. You are going to be tormented day and night. He will not allow you to have a breathing space now, because your covenant with death is broken, and you have been using Jesus. If you have been calling the devil or saying in the name of devil or Lucifer without saying in the name of Jesus or Holy Spirit, he wouldn't have been so angry, no, with you like that. But because you are using his name, you are using his name to cover your idol. Use Jesus to wrap your idol. But inside is a strong demon. You have become a prominent shrine. But God said that he will bring you down. He is bringing you down now. The kind of shame, if somebody prophesy or tell you what is coming upon you now, you not believe. The kind of shame, or the type, or the way, I don't know how to tell you. The thing I saw coming upon you, evil pastors, you at every is great. Escape for your life. Confess your sins. Tell Jesus, come out and tell people that I have been using in the name of Jesus, but it's not him that is in me. Tell them the one inside of you. Can't you see? They love you so much. They are calling you daddy, daddy G O, daddy, daddy, everybody, daddy, daddy. Can't you see? Inside of you, you know what I'm talking about. You are crying inside of you. You are in pain. You know those things you are calling Jesus. It's not Jesus. You don't know Jesus. You don't know the truth. You Yoruba man doesn't believe 100% in the supernatural power of God. You don't know that God is so powerful. God is a consuming fire until you come to know the power in Him. Then you will know that what you are doing is useless. There's no power in those nonsense. They are all calamity, death, shame, disgrace, poverty. You pack private jets, that is not the issue. You have how many millions of people following you? That is not the issue now. The issue is that Jesus wants to face to face. He wants to face you now, face to face. You know, all the evil that you are doing in His name, He wants to face you now, face to face. If you can be able to fight, or you are fighting, two of you should face each other. I hand you over to Him. I have given you what He said. Face Him now. And all of you that have been chained, or caused pain, or that is being possessed by evil spirit there, I pray for God to have mercy and deliver all of you from the hand of the evil ones. And it's time for you to tell yourself the truth. All you, the followers, begin to tell yourself the truth, because I know that some of you will say, who is this man talking this? Who is this man saying this? I am nobody, but don't provoke something for yourself as you hear this. Just pray. If you're a child of God, just go ahead and pray. Pray. Because if you're trying, you can cause yourself a problem by saying something or making a comment that you will bring something upon yourself. I'm not telling you not to do. You can go ahead and do. You know, I'm not telling not to attack. You know, even I expect you at table. If you feel that I insulted you or that maybe I sin myself, you can attack and see what happens. You can try to attack me. You can try to come up and attack. Let us see. You know, because I've been seeing you guys in the spirit. You know, and you guys know that I know who I am. So if you feel that maybe the person talking to you want to, you know, insult you, I want to disgrace you, or I'm talking out of my own self, or I'm talking out of self, or I send myself, you can attack me, you know. You claim because of the level you are, you know, as a man, you know, a tiny man like me, you know, the level you have got, you can see yourself more powerful than me. But you can try and see whether truly you are more powerful than me. Jesus in me is so powerful. Try it and see what happens to you. If you try, I know I'll be very happy if you can do that. Attack me spiritually. I would like you to attack. Launch the attack and see what happened to you. Okay, my people, love you so much. The devil is a liar from the pit of hell. And every devil must be arrested now. The one that is still operating there that you guys did not know. I'm interested to see that all of them are flushed down to the pit of hell where they are meant to. I love you guys so much. My happiness is to see all of you enjoying this life. For how long will Africa, the land of Africa, keep tormenting the inhabitants? For how long will the people of Africa keep giving the citizens pains? For how long will the souls of men and the women that are supposed to enjoy life be in groan, be in pain? God wants to see you free from the hand of the enemy, the hand of the evil ones, the hand of the devil, the hand of the false prophets and pastors and devils and demons. God wants you out now to enjoy life. See you sometimes, you know, and keep checking on me, and you'll be blessed forever. I love you. Remain blessed. Bye.